porch. Okay? Now, when you put the porch on the side, it becomes a lanai. When you put the porch on the back, you put the patio. The porch kasi is usually it's an outside that we have a stair here in a railing, right? The foyer is when you enter some place and you have a main door. It will be the living room and then you have another door. So this is what you call the foyer. It's a place where foyer where you think of where you're going. See, let's make another example.
Parang
siya yung dunong nag-antay yung tao. But some people would not have a foyer, they would have a porch na lang. Okay? Make example of...
porch. Ano yung silikod?
Patio.
Patio.
Basilio?
Basilio?
Basilio!
Foyer. Okay? This could be a foyer. But some... kitchen. Okay? It could look something like this one. Or... no, vice versa, sorry. A kitchen living room. Okay, that could be a foyer. Now...
sure.
Sa ibang dictionary naman, the terrace naman, could term as the terrace, this could be term as a terrace.
Sure,
okay,
sure.
Iba banalized terraces. But then again, on some terms naman, they call a terrace when it's very big. So you have a big house, then you have the overhang here, they call this a terrace. Some would term it as that. But when you say it's a balcony, it's the small thing where Romeo and Juliet are talking to each other. Mas maliit na siya. Okay? So the terrace is a bigger one, the balcony is a smaller one. Okay? Now what else?
Veranda, sir.
Ano pinapagawa sa inside? Ano dito? Ano pinapagawa sa floor plan?
Ano yung veranda? Sir, ano veranda?
The veranda in Lanai is mostly the same. Sometimes you have a colonnade. Say you have a colonnade.
Sir, what's a colonnade?
Imagine nyo ito.
Ah, okay.
Then you have a colonnade.
Nalabas. Sure, parang Japanese. Okay. Parang Japanese.
Well, it's usually at the side. If you put it in the front, you call it a porch. But on the side, it's called a lanai or a veranda. Okay? Iba. So, yun muna. Yan yung...
sir? Sir?
Ngayon, did the teacher teach you what is the size of the furniture?
No.
The door, the window, yes?
No, sir.
Wala
sir?
Pa na? Wala pa siya?
Sir, it's not a top view, it's side view. Section, diba?
You're required to do a section. Kasi guys, yung sa door, usually sa main door, the width, it is a width, 0.90 ang main door. Ang rooms mo, from point AB. Okay? Then ang toilet mo, mga 0.70. Sometimes 0.60. Okay? So ito yung mga sizes. If you make a door that's almost 1 meter big, usually the problem lies, the door becomes heavy. So we do not put a little bit too much. Now, our problem is, this is the width. Now, what is about the height? Now, the height of a door is usually around 2.10. This is the usual one. Now, I do not want to use the word standard because there are always different standards. When you use a standard in the Philippines, it's different for the states, no? So usually, hindi naman ganun katangkad ng sa Pilipinas. So, we do not usually follow, not always follow the states. And it's when you buy at the market, what people usually want is usually yung ano nagagawa. Okay, what is finished. So usually people use a door of 2.1. But in my projects, I sometimes use 2.4 or 2.2. Now why is that? Is that because when the room is kind of high, let's say you have a high ceiling, the door looks pretty small. It's look in proportion. But when you put the door upwards, make it higher, it becomes more grander. Okay? So it depends. But right now, if you're going to give to Mercado, you could just use 2.1. Okay, that's the standard size. And then this is the usual sizes of the main door, the room, and the TND of the door. Now for windows, ang usually problem lang naman ng windows is yung height. This is usually at about 0.90. Okay? This is what you call the FFL. You know what an FFL is?
No.
You call it a finished floor line. Okay? So from the ground, from the floor, you have about 0.90 meters on the window. Okay? Now some would use 0.70, much, much lower, para kumuha siya picture window. Picture window is what you call a window that makes a frame on the outside view. Okay? But not in the city, we hardly have a picture window because there's not much view outside anyway. Okay? So, the height of a window is 0.90. Now, what about the height of this window? You usually make this as high as the height of the door. So, if your door is like this one, you make it equal to the height of the window. Okay? So that's for residential. Now, what are other things that you would want to ask when designing a... You ask for the section, nga pala. Try to make the section. Now, for the section, are you required to do a two-story or single-story?
Yung house po mismo.
Single-story.
Or condo.
Oh, okay. Let's make first a single-story, no? Single-story have a roof like this one. Usually you have a wall of about 0.10 or 0.15 meters. Okay?
Hello sir, ano yan?
Ha?
Ano yan?
This is the section.
Huh?
Ah. Ay, parang hinahati mo yung house.
Hinahati. Well, this is what happens when you cut the house in half. Okay? So, the section, this is the finished floor line. But there's a problem in this section. What is the problem? The problem is the interior floor line of the house is the same as the outside. So better put the house a little bit higher than the outside. Okay? Make it higher. So that when the water goes in, it doesn't come inside the house. Usually the height is about 0.30 meters. Okay? So sometimes you would put a stair here to prevent the water from going in. So as much as possible when you make a house, do not make the floor of the house the same with the road. Okay, make it higher, 0.13. Now, another thing to watch out on the section is the roof. Now, the roof is kind of complicated. Even the fourth year or third year done doesn't even know how to draw the roof yet. It's kind of... But right now, a simple one would be... do you know a beam?
Yes, I-beam.
The beam? Okay, let's make an example. Okay, it's the beam. Make an X here. And make another X. Then you have the roof. And that's it. Okay, now if you have what you call the gutter, you know what the gutter is?
Yes, sir.
The gutter hangs around here. Okay, it hangs around here. And then you put the ceiling here. Okay? So this is how it looks on the section. The water goes down here and goes to the house. Okay, but it's kind of complex. No, no need for that. I guess Architect Mercado is kind of happy with how this would look. Sometimes you would just like, see, trust, detail. Okay?
Sir.
No need to draw anything. Some people would shake it all the way, no? But no need. Now, in the interior, you could actually put some... Actually, I think what Architect Mercado wants is you put a chair here. Alright? And maybe you put a base. And put a picture frame. I don't know. But I am the person also. Not complex.